pv raised to n equals to constant, and adiabatic process follows the law pv raised to gamma equals to constant. The notation of n and gamma are, n is called polytropic index, and the value of n varies for different type of the gas used in the system. We don't have a fixed value for n, like how we are having gamma is 1.4 for air, like that. We don't have a fixed value for polytropic. In a polytropic process, the expression for a polytropic process P1V1 minus P2V2 divided by n minus 1. So these are the most important concept what we learned. You remember PV diagram? So variety of process and the expression for work done. Apart from this, we have discussed other kinds of the work transfer. Other kinds of work transfer are, first one is our electrical work, second one is stirrer work, third one is magnetic work, fourth one is flow work. Okay, like that variety of works we studied. These are the work transfer other than PDB work. Okay, so whenever I ask, explain the different types of work transfer, this you have to explain these work transfer. The screen is visible for you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Okay. Now, in this class, I'm going to solve some problems, numerical problems on work transfer. Okay. Before that, just I'm going to explain how to find out the value of n. Okay, as we have gamma as ratio of specific heats, so by knowing Cp and Cv, so we can calculate the value of gamma, that is 1.4. But how to calculate polytropic index? We derived expression for work done during polytropic process. It is exactly similar to that of adiabatic process. The work done during polytropic process given by P1V1 minus P2V2 divided by n minus 1. Okay, where P1V1 are the pressure and volume at state point 1, P2V2 are the pressure and volume at state point 2, and n is the polytropic index. This is the procedure to find out the value of n. Sometimes they used to ask, find out the value of n in the numerical problem. So before that, you should know how to get the value of n, that is polytropic index. Okay. We know that the polytropic process follows the law PV raised to n equals to constant. Suppose if you take that process between two states 1 and 2, we can write P1 V1 to the power of n equals to P2 V to the power of n equals to constant. Okay, the general equation is different, and whenever you are taking the same equation between the state point, you have to write like this. Okay, general equation is PV raised to n equals to constant. Suppose if you take that polytropic process between the two state points, we are going to write the equation as V1 to the power of n equals to V2 to the power of n equals to constant. Now we have to take logarithm on both sides. So whenever you take the log on both sides, we can write ln P1 plus n into ln V1. Okay, already you know taking the logarithm. So taking logarithm on both sides, we can write ln means natural logarithm to the base log to the base e plus n into ln V1 equals to ln P2 plus n into ln V2. Okay, so you can write like this. Just you take the logarithm on both sides. Now you have to make the common terms. Okay, here in the left hand side we are having ln vn, and you shift that ln vn to the LHS. You segregate the terms and make the common terms one side. Okay, n into the bracket ln v1 minus of ln v2. I am taking this term towards left hand side. Now I am writing the terms for right hand side, that is ln p2 and minus ln p1. Okay, this one I am going to take. So now from this one we are going to find out the value of n. N is nothing but ln p2 minus ln p1 divided by ln v1 minus ln of v2. And you have to apply logarithm rule, that is log x minus log y equals to log of x by y. Same principle you apply here. So you get n as ln into p2 by p1 divided by ln into v1 by v2. Okay, so you remember this equation to find out the value of n when p1, p2, v1 and v2 are known. This is a standard equation to find out the polytropic index, and the standard equation to find out adiabatic index is the ratio of Cp and Cv. Okay, so hope you understood this one. Very simple formula. You have to remember ln of p2 by p1 divided by ln of v1 by v2, where v1 and v2 are the volume at state point 1, and p1 and p2 are the pressure at state point 1 and 2 respectively. This is the procedure to find out the value of n whenever they ask. Nothing but real gas. Any
Should we leave?
Yeah, come on.
Mass
How
bomb.
should we leave? Ask in WhatsApp if you will join. Okay.
Sorry, students, there is some internet connection problem. Okay. So now I'll continue the session. There are some problems in internet connection. Okay. That's why it was disconnected. Now I'll continue. Okay. Is it visible screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I'll dictate the problem once again. Okay. You see the problem. A spherical balloon of 0.8 meter diameter contains gas at 120 kilopascal. The gas in the balloon is heated until the pressure reaches 425 kilopascal, during which the gas pressure is proportional to the cube of diameter of the balloon. Determine the work done by the gas inside the balloon. Okay. So as we know that as the temperature increases, the pressure also increases. Same concept here also. We are having a spherical balloon initially having the diameter of 0.8 meter and pressure of 120 kilopascal. When you supply the heat, is proportional to so P1 is 1.
Sir, we are not able to hear.
Sir, your voice is breaking, sir.
Okay. Break, sir.
Okay, I'll repeat because once again there are some internet connection problem. Hope all of you are seeing the screen now. Okay, so P equals to CD cube, P1 equals to C into D1 cube. From this
one, it's not visible.
Not visible.
No, sir.
Okay, 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 I'll say once. Now it is visible?
Yes, sir.
Oh. Okay. So first you have to write the given data. D1 equals to 0.8 meter. Gas pressure P1 is to 120 kilopascal. Convert in Pascal. That is 120 into 10 to the power of 3. P is proportional to D cube given in the problem. We can write P equals to CD cube, where C is the constant of proportionality. Suppose you take for the statement, I can write P1 equals to C into D1 cube. From this one here, P1 is given. How much? 120 kilopascal. And D1 is given 0.8 meter cube, 0.8 meter. So we have to find out the value of C. Value of C is nothing but the constant of proportionality. Okay. C is 120 into 10 to the power of cube divided by 0.8 cube. So we are going to get the value of C as 234.37 into 10 to the power of 3. Suppose we are going to express in kilopascal, we can write the value of C as 234.37. Okay. Next, similarly, we have to find out what is the diameter, initial diameter they are given, but they are not given the final diameter. When the heat is supplied, the gas pressure in the balloon gets increased. We know P1 and D1 and also P2 value is given, but we don't know what is the diameter. Obviously, diameter will be increased as the heat is supplied. As the pressure increases, as the temperature increases, pressure also increases. You remember, there will be a direct relationship between pressure and temperature. Okay, P2 is given 425 kilopascal in the problem. You convert in 425 into 10 to the power of 3, that is pascal in it. Okay, and we have found out the value of C. The value of C is 234.37. Just now we got the value of C as 234.37 into 10 to the power of cube. That is this one. You have to take pascal in it only, because one more thing you remember, you have to take similar in. Suppose you are taking kilopascal, you have to take kilopascal in right hand side also. Suppose you are taking pascal in it, you have to take pascal in the right hand side. Okay, so 425 into 10 to the power of cube equals to 234.37 into 10 to the power of cube into D cube, D2 cube. No, you have to simplify the equation. So D2 cube we have to find out. Then in order to find out D2, we have to take to the power of 1 by 3. Okay, in your calculator. So use the calculator, find out the value of D2. And we'll get the value of D2 as 1.18 meter. You remember, the value of D2 should be more than your D1, because as we supply the heat, diameter in the starting, we are having the diameter as 0.8. After heating, the pressure increases and diameter also increases. So we are getting D2 is 1.18 meter. Okay. And next step, how to find out the work done. Okay. As I said, for all the problems, you have to remember the standard equation. And that is W equals to integration of PdV. Okay. And one more thing here. After integration, what will get? P into V2 minus V1. Okay. So, P, don't take the varied one. You have to take the initial pressure value, remember, and the change in volume, that is V2 minus V1, we have to find out. Okay. So, here remember most important concept. So, P into integration of dV, P into V2 minus V1. Okay, it is, we have to take the initial condition pressure. Don't take the final condition pressure here, remember. So while solving the problem, we have to take the initial condition. Initial condition is 120 kilopascal into V2 minus V1. And the shape of the balloon is of spherical type. We know that the volume of a sphere is given by pi d cube divided by 6. So using that equation, we have to find out the value of volume 1 and volume 2. Okay? So V1 equals to pi D1 cube divided by 6, and V2 is pi D2 cube divided by 6. Okay. So we have to find out the value of V1. V1 is pi by 6 into D1 we know 0.82, we get 0.267 meter cube, and V2 is pi by 6 into D2 cube. So pi by 6 into 1.218 meter cube. So we'll get V2 as 0.946. Okay. So substitute the value of P into V2 minus V1. So we got P as 120 into 10 to the power of meter cube into 0.946 is our V2 and 0.267 is our V1. So by substituting the value, we'll get W as 81.48 kilojoules. Okay. Okay, so we're getting the value of W as 81.48 kilojoules, and the magnitude is positive. We know that magnitude is positive in case of work done by the system, and magnitude is negative in case of the work done on the system. So plus sign indicate that work is done by the system. So this much of amount of the work done takes place whenever we're going to supply the heat to the balloon. Okay. Understood? Any doubts in this problem? So most important problem, this one. Anybody? Understood? Understood the problem, guys?
Yes, sir.
Ah, good. Okay. So no doubts. Okay, now I'll explain another problem. Okay. You see, the second, third problem is exactly similar to first problem. But here, in the previous problem, the gas pressure was directly proportional to the cube of diameter. But in this problem, the pressure is proportional to only diameter. Okay, so I'll solve this problem, same kind. Okay. You see this problem, a spherical balloon of 1 meter diameter contains gas at 240 kilopascal. That is, P1 is 240 kilopascal and T1 is 290 Kelvin. Okay. When the gas inside the balloon is heated, the pressure changes to 485 kilopascal and pressure is proportional to the diameter. Determine the work done by the gas inside the balloon. The same kind, the magnitude change. And instead of P proportional to D cube, here P is proportional to D. Okay. So first P is proportional to D. We can write P equals to C into D, where C is the constant of proportionality. P is 240 kilopascal, C into diameter, initial diameter is 1 meter. From this one, you can find out the value of C. Okay. 240 kilopascal will get. Similarly, we can write P2 equals to C into D2. So P2 is given 485 kilopascal. C, just now we found out it is 240 into D2. Okay, D2 we are getting it as 2.02 meter. Okay, initial diameter is 1 meter. After heating, we'll get the final diameter as 2.02 meter. Okay. And here, so I'll explain how to find out the work done. This is a method to find out the work done. As we know that the work done in PdV work or displacement work is integration of PdV. Okay. So V equals to pi by 6 d cube. We know that V equals to pi by 6 into d cube. Okay. So you have to differentiate, simple differentiation on both sides. You'll get dV equals to the integral of, differentiation of pi by 6 into d cube is pi d squared by 2 into dd. Okay. So it's a variable dV equals to pi d squared by d into dd. Okay. You take the simple differentiation on both sides, you'll get this dV equals to pi d squared divided by 2 into dd. Now you have to write the standard equation W122 equals to integration of PdV. So integration of PdV, P equals to what? P equals to we know that, you see, P equals to CD. Just you substitute the value of P as CD. CD is constant because constant of proportionally diameter you have to take outside integration of dV. And what is the dV value? dV value is pi d square divided by 2 into dd. Now you have to replace these two terms, P as CD and dV as pi d square divided by 2 into dd. Okay. Because you have to take the CD inside the integral because dV is given by pi d square divided by 2 into dd because diameter is a variable term. Okay, don't take this diameter outside the integral. You have to take the diameter inside the integral. Okay, integration of C into pi d square divided by d into dd. Okay, and now say you take C constant, pi by 8 constant. Okay, and you have to integrate d square dd. Okay, just you have to integrate d square dd. So after solving, you'll get d 2 to the power of 4 minus d 1 to the power of 4. Okay, so c is 240 we got after solving, 240. Okay, into pi by 8. Just you have to substitute and simplify, apply the integration, substitute the value, you'll get the answer. Okay, c is 240, pi is constant. Okay, divided by 8. D2, what we got, it is 2.02 minus initial diameter is 1 to the power of 4, like that. So you can solve the problem. Okay, so in the previous problem it was d cube, here it is d. Okay, but you should remember this equation, v equals to pi by 6 d cube. You have to differentiate because we are having dv in the standard equation, that you have to replace the term dv, and p is nothing but cd. Just you have to substitute the whatever value constant further you have to take outside and inside one, you are getting this one. Okay, here we'll get the answer as 1474.198 kilojoules. Okay, so once again the magnitude is plus. You remember the sign convention in work transfer, whenever work done on the system it is negative, work done by the system is positive. So like that in heat transfer also, the whenever the heat added to the system it is positive, whenever the heat is taken from the system it is negative. So you should remember the sign convention. Here you are getting positive magnitude, you have to write the work done by the system. Okay, okay, another problem I'll solve. Okay, like that they'll ask. Okay, 0.115 meter cube of gas has a pressure of 138 kilopascal or kilonewton per meter square and it is compressed, okay, to 680 kilonewton per meter square according to the law PV raised to 1.4 equals to constant. You remember there are two terms, one is expansion and another one is compression. Okay, when in case of compression, the pressure increases, you remember, 138 to 680. And in case of expansion process pressure decreases. Pressure of 138 kilonewton per meter square, that is P1, it is compressed. Okay, whenever you compress the gas, the pressure increases. Here also same thing, it increased to 680 kilopascal according to the law PV raised to 1.4 equals to constant. As we know that PV raised to 1.4 is nothing but our gamma, it is adiabatic process, determine the volume of the gas after compression. Here three values are given, okay, four values are given, you have to find out unknown thing, that is V2 you have to find out. Okay, P1 is given, okay, V1 is given, P2 is given, gamma is given 1.4, and you have to find out what is the value of V2. Okay, how to find out value of V2? Very simple equation. First you have to write the given equation. Given equation is PV raised to 1.4 equals to constant. Whenever you are taking between the two state points, you have to write down P1 V1 to the power of 1.4 equals to e2 e to the power of 1.4 equals to constant. Okay, so you can rewrite the equation like this: p1 by p2 equals to v2 by v1 to the power of 1.4. Okay, so our aim is to find out v2. What you can do, you divide the power by 1.4, because suppose you are taking, it's very difficult to solve the problem. In that case, in order to make the process simple, just you have to divide the power by 1.4 on both sides. Here, that is p1 divided by p2 to the power of 1 divided by 1.4 equals to v2 by v1 to the power of 1.4 divided by 1.4, means you get 1. So divide the power on both sides by 1.4. So v2 by v1 to the power of 1 equals to, I'm writing the RHS term here, okay, and then I'm writing the LHS term here. So v2 by v1 to the power of 1.4 divided by 1.4 is nothing but 1. So our aim is to find out v2. v2 equals to v1 into p1 by p2 to the power of 1 divided by 1.4. Okay, this is the procedure to find out v2. Okay, now we have to substitute all the given values in this equation. V1 is 0.115 given in the problem. P1 is 138 kilopascal, and P2 is 680. And 1 divided by 1.4 is nothing but 0.714. So by solving this problem, we are getting the value as 0.068 meter. Sometimes they used to ask to find out the work done during this process. So work done during this process is P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by gamma minus 1. P1 we know, that is 138 into 10 to the power of 3 into V1 is 0.115. Minus P2 is 680 into 10 to the power of 3 into V2, just now we got 0.0368 divided by 1.4 minus 1. So by substituting these values, I will get the value of work done. Okay, sometimes in this problem they are not asked, just they asked how to find out the value of V2. Okay. And I'll explain one more most important problem. Okay, so such kind of question carries 10 marks. So this is the question asked so many times in the VTU exam. Okay, the pressure volume relationship is given by P equals to 8 minus 4V. Okay, this is the relation given in the problem, P equals to 8 minus 4V and pressure in bar. Okay, bar is the unit of pressure and 1 bar equals to 10 to the power of 5 Pascal. It is 1 into 10 to the power of 5 Newton per meter square, because 1 Newton per meter square equals to 1 Pascal, where V is in meter cube. If 130 kilojoule of work is supplied to the system, you remember, whenever work done on the system is negative. Okay, here you have to take the magnitude as negative, because work is supplied to the system, that is work is done on the system. Calculate the final pressure and volume of the system. Take the initial volume as 0.5 meter cube. Okay. First, we have to write the given equation. P equals to 8 minus 4V bar. Okay, bar means you have to convert in Pascal. 1 Pascal equals to 10 to the power of 5 Newton per meter square. Same thing you rewrite here. 8 minus 4V into 10 to the power of 5. Instead of bar, you have to write Newton per meter square, because 10 to the power of 5 Pascal equals to 1 bar. Okay. Next step, you have to, as I said, you have to write the standard equation for PdV work or displacement work. W122 equals to integration of PdV between the limits 1 to 2. So in this problem, P is given, that is 8 minus 4V. Just you have to substitute the value of P from the given equation in the standard equation. P is nothing but 8 minus 4V into 10 to the power of 5 into dV, you write as it is. Okay, don't change this one. Just you have to substitute the value of P from the given equation in the standard equation. Okay. Integration of 8 minus 4V into 10 to the power of 5 dV. Now, so you have to analyze the constant term. Constant term is 10 to the power of 5. You have to take outside. and you have to integrate the remaining part. That is 8 minus 4, you have to integrate. As I said, once again, you have to segregate into two terms. One is 8v. So you have to integrate. Integration of 8dv is nothing but 8v. And integration of 4v is nothing but 4v squared divided by 2. So you have to integrate separately. Okay, integration of 8dv is 8v. Integration of 4v with respect to dv is 4v squared divided by 2. Between the limits 0.5, because it's a v1 is 0.5, but we don't know v2. Just you write v2 as it is. Now next step is you have to substitute the upper and lower limits. Okay, so 10 to the power of 5 constant you keep as it is. Okay, in the bracket 8 into v2 minus v1. V2 you write as it is, minus v1 is 0.5 given in the problem. 4v squared divided by 2 is nothing but 2v squared. Now you substitute upper and lower limits. 2 is constant, you take outside. In the bracket v2 square we don't know, minus v1 square is nothing but 0.5 square. Okay, whatever the things are known, just you write as it is. Okay, now simplify. 10 to the power of 5 into 8v2 is nothing but 8v2 minus 8 into 0.5 is 4 minus 2v2 square minus 2 into 0.5 square is nothing but 0.5. So simplify the equation. Next you will get, now you'll get 8v2. Okay, now what I'm going to do, just I'm taking the minus outside. Okay, minus, I'm going to change the sign. Whatever you are getting, I'm going to take the minus, because everything will get changed in the inside equation. That is 2v2 square, instead of minus, just you write plus, because we're having minus outside. 2v2 square and plus 8v2, I'm writing it as minus 8v2, because minus is outside. Just I'm changing the sign. And here, minus 4, minus 4.5, you get minus 4.5. Don't write minus 4.5, you have to write plus 4.5, because I'm taking the minus as outside. Okay, so these are the steps you have to follow. Okay, next step. Okay, 130 kilojoule of work is done on the system. Now we got the expression, this value of work done. But in the problem, 130 kilojoule of work is applied to the system. Now we have to equate this value with 130 kilojoule, because work done, what we are getting is the expression for work done. Work done is given in the problem, that is 130. Don't take positive. Suppose you take positive, it is wrong, because work is done on the system. Suppose if you make simile mistake also, you don't get the correct answer. So therefore, you should be very careful in solving the problem, especially in plus and minus. Suppose if you miss one minus wrong, entire problem becomes wrong. That's why be careful, write all the magnitudes properly. So that is minus 130. And once again, don't put it in the kilojoules. I am putting in the joules, because in the right hand side I am having the Pascal. That's why you have to maintain the same units. Suppose you miss 10 to the power of 3 wrong. That's why be careful in writing the LHS term. That is 130 kilojoule, you have to write 130 into 10 to the power of 3 joules, and you have to write the minus. And right hand side you write as it is. Okay, don't change. Why I took minus means I had to cancel this minus both sides. That's why I took minus outside. Okay, minus minus gets cancelled. After that, you have to simplify the equation. You'll get the equation as 2v2 square minus 8v2 plus 3.5. Okay, you have to simplify. So after simplification, I wrote this equation as 2v2 square minus 8v2 plus 3.2. Now here, this is the quadratic equation. You already know how to find out the roots of quadratic equation. That is, you had, I hope you remember, minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Okay, so this is the standard equation to find out the roots of a quadratic equation. Okay, minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Okay, now you have to substitute the coefficient. This is the coefficient of a, this is the coefficient of b, and this is the coefficient of c. Okay, so minus b, that is coefficient of b is minus 8. Minus of minus 8 plus or minus square root of minus 8 square or plus 8 square, both are, you get same value, minus 4 into 2 into 3.2. So you have to substitute the value of A, B, C, coefficients of A and B and C. But you should remember this equation. You studied in mathematics. You should remember this equation to find out the roots of quadratic equation. So, because we are having plus or minus, you'll get two values. You'll not get one value. So, after solving this one, we are getting two values. One value is 3.549 and another value is 0.451. Okay. Then which value you are going to select? Anybody? In order to find out V2, which value you are going to select? Okay. Which is correct value? Anybody?
So value with lower value, one with lower
value. Why lower value? Why not higher value?
Final, sir. Final it is. So it will be lower than the initial. The question also is written.
No, actually, I got this one. My aim, I got V2. Okay, my aim is to find out final value, which value you are going to select. Okay, and you have to justify your reason. Okay.
Sir, P2 cannot be negative.
P2 cannot be negative. No, we got both as positively, right? In the quadratic equation.
Sir, no, V2 is positive, but P2, sir.
P2 cannot be negative.
Yeah, because if we take 3, it will become minus 12 figure 8 and then it will be negative.
Good. Okay. So, you cannot take higher value. You have to take a lower value because now you have to analyze the relationship between pressure and volume. You remember, as the pressure increases, it is inversely proportional. Okay. Volume decreases. Okay. So, you should get a lower value than that of higher value. So be careful while selecting the value. So you have to take 0.451 only. You have to reject this term 3.549. So you have to analyze and you have to give the reason why you have selected V2. V2 is 0.451 meter cube. Okay, next time our aim is to find out P2. P2 is simple. We have standard equation. P equals to 8 minus 4V. So just you substitute for second condition, P2 equals to 8 minus 4V2. So 8 is constant, 4 is constant. You have to substitute the value of V2 as 0.451 meter cube. Okay, don't take 3.454 and you'll get the wrong answer. Okay. So after solving, you will get the value of P2 as 6.196 bar. Okay, what about P1? You see, P1 is we are having otherwise, you can find out P1 also. P1 is 8 minus 4V1. Okay. That is also correct. Okay. You can find out P1 and P2. But in our problem, they asked V2 and P2. Okay. P2 is 8 minus 4V2. So, you'll get 6.96 bar. Okay. This is one of the important problem. Okay. So, remember, you have to write the units properly. Okay. 10 to the power of 5 you have to take. And another important concept is it is work done on the system. That is, you have to write minus in the LHS term. Suppose if you write plus sign wrong, you will not get the correct value. And one more thing. So here you are converting bar and you have to convert work done instead of kilojoule, you have to convert joules. And you should know that how to find out the roots of quadratic equation and two values and which value you are going to select. That is most important. Hope you understood this problem. Okay. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Good. So, like that, only they'll ask in the exam. Okay. So, all of you have to, such kind of problems are available in the textbook. So, all of you have to practice the problem because problems are most important part in thermodynamics. You are having one theory question and another one is a problematic question. So, one question carries 10 marks, but the problem carries 10 marks. In all the chapters, we are having the numerical problems. Okay. So, that you should be well aware of the numerical problems, how to solve the problems, how to get the values. Okay. Thank you. I'll stop the session now. Thank you.